Welcome to the Village Shops, Ruskin, Florida. This is DWI Right Now, episode 36. I'm Alex Green, co-host in the booth with me.
I'm Anthony Devlin. Very special day here at DWI. We're celebrating a very, very, very special birthday right now.
James is
going
to
shoot it over
now.
To James in the ring. Asking the fans if they are ready for some DWI right now. And of course, they're all in unison with the... That was weird.
We do.
Bit creepy.
Happy birthday. Velma.
Yeah.
Is celebrating 98 years young.
What a milestone. 98 years
beautiful
old.
Beautiful Velma, 98 years old. I have to say our greatest fan. If I'm not mistaken, she has been coming to DWI since we kicked off in 2009. And now she's celebrating her 98th birthday with us. And we're hoping that she can be here next year celebrating her 99th.
Definitely DWI faithful. Never misses a show unless she absolutely have to.
I don't think she's ever missed one. Gotta say.
And it looks like we're about to get underway with the action here at the Village Shops.
That's how good the action is here.
And what are we going to see in our first match? How are we kicking off Thelma's birthday celebration?
I don't know. I'm over here with you. You tell me. What the heck was that? There's a frog in the microphone here.
Uh-oh.
Oh,
your former
it's
tag
my
team
boy
partner.
Aaron Nova kicking the show off this week with the Swagtastic Super Kid Wonder Nova Supernova.
Held the tag team championships with you for almost 2 years.
We really did have a great run. It was a little over a year, I would think.
You guys won the inaugural tag team championship tournament together and made it all the way to the finals in the second annual tag team tournament. It was quite the run.
We did good. We had fun. We learned a lot. We grew as people. I grew as a person.
Nova's fired up.
I gained a really good friend. And I got to see the growth and the beginnings of a very
Swagtastic superstar here at Definitive Wrestling International.
Very, very interesting career. I'm looking forward to seeing great things from the Swagtastic Captain Nova.
Uh-oh.
Who's this now? Who we got?
Current light heavyweight champion. The jerk Eric Curtis makes his way to the ring here at DWI Volume 201.
This guy.
He has dominated the competition in the light heavyweight division at Definitive Wrestling International for quite some time now. He won the title from Snoop Strikes. There's only been one fluke loss on his run to Alex Perry, and he won it right back to be a two-time DWI
right
light heavyweight champion.
Right on cue. Well, I'd say... I mean, I'd really like to get another shot at him. I didn't fare very well the first time, but I think I need to get that shot back.
You are a former two-time DWI light heavyweight championship. What a match that would be.
Well, I'm ready anytime. Let's do that. I'm ready for that. Well, that is, unless my boy Aaron Nova dethrones the champ. It's not a title match. What is going on here? Let's hear.
That's what Nova just said.
Oh, it's non-title.
The jerk.
Well, that don't mean
want
nothing.
Nova to earn the shot.
I'll tell you what, it doesn't mean nothing. Nova can beat him and then just beat him again later and become the champ. That is, unless I get my rematch. What does he got to say here?
He just fixed the mic with one touch.
You're referring to me, I believe. Oh.
He's in the commentary booth, Eric.
Giving Aaron Nova the ring where he deserves.
Dax not at ringside. Eric,
the insurance policy has been taken out and let it lapse. No more insurance policy.
Which he has done that here to finish the
fair
match.
Enough. About bored.
No one threatening to hurt the members of the light heavyweight division.
Nah, he ain't. Yeah, that was on a fluke accident. It had nothing to do with him. It was actually while he was performing a maneuver on the jerk.
He is taking full credit here at the Village Shops.
This is the kind of thing he would do, isn't it?
Oh, now he's threatening to hurt Nova.
I want to see how he fares now without the insurance policy. Now that the insurance policy is gone. Again, he did beat us straight up, but That insurance policy was always looming and a distraction. Now he doesn't have that distraction. Let's see what happens.
It's a non-title matchup. Swagtastic Aaron Nova, the jerk Eric Curtis, one-on-one. It's DWI volume 201 since 2009. Wow. Senior referee Ray Riviera checked both men, and it looks like we're about to get underway. And here we go.
Nova sucking him in, knowing that he would go for him with a cheap shot. Sucked him right in. Gives a right hand for his troubles.
Punching him right in the mouth to start things off.
Dropping here. The jerk, Eric Curtis.
And Nova's fired up.
Nova knows one gear, and that's top.
And Eric Curtis regrouping outside. Here comes Swagtastic Aaron. Nova blocks the punch.
What did that mean? Who knows?
He just told her he punched her in the face for her birthday. Boom, oh. Eric Curtis.
Come on, Nova, there he goes. Fights right back.
They're brawling outside the ring right here in front of the fans. Tickets are only $5. The action's literally right in your lap.
In your face.
And Nova still in control here early, almost taunting the jerk. Huge shoulders.
You know, driving his shoulders into the midsection of the jerk, Eric Curtis.
And Nova's, he's been in control the entire start of this matchup. Eric Curtis went for the jump start and tried to jump him as he was taking his vest off.
That was a mistake.
And Nova all the way across the ring.
Oh. A sliding drop kick, basement drop kick to the sternum.
Nova taking Price it out
is not
on the
vomiting.
Jerk. The jerk Eric Curtis, he wanted to say bad things, saying Aaron Nova isn't ready to fly solo here at DWI. And Nova's taking it to him. It appears he took those comments personal. And he's choking the life out of the jerk here. Almost a dragon sleeper. You can hear the fans firmly behind Aaron Nova, a fan favorite here at the Village Shops.
Big scoop slam.
Now Nova's in the best shape that I have personally seen him in.
He's been working hard. Again. He's just at the beginning of his career.
I'm excited to see what 2017 has in store for Aaron Nova.
The metamorphosis is going to be amazing.
Eric Curtis makes his way back to his feet, trying to turn things around here. One. And Eric Curtis regrouping on the floor. And what is Aaron Nova going to do here? Eric Curtis regrouping on the outside. Aaron Nova's been putting a beating on him. And ooh.
Catches a humongous forearm for his trouble.
It looked like Nova was going to go for the suicide dive. And he caught an elbow right in the mouth.
Well, he did. Oh. The jerk using the ropes, catching him in the midsection with those cables.
And Aaron Nova wailed in pain off of that. Eric Curtis putting the boots in Nova now. And Nova was in firm control of this matchup, but just like that, Eric Curtis takes
time.
Control.
Again, this is Aaron Nova is a work in progress. That midsection's a bit on the soft side, and it looks like Eric Curtis is taking advantage of that. Now he's just choking him.
Curtis told the referee to shut up because he was admonishing him for blatantly breaking the rules.
Why waste your energy when you can just choke the guy, right?
And Eric Curtis looking to prove a point here on swagtastic Aaron Nova. Applying the rear chin lock, choking the life out of him. And the fans getting behind Aaron Nova.
Oh, Nova, definitely a fan favorite here at Definitive Wrestling.
Eric Curtis with a drop down.
Oh.
And he just kicked his head off signature, Eric Curtis.
Big wheel kick to the head.
Unable to get the two count. Aaron Nova just getting his shoulder off the mat.
Definitely going to take a little bit more than that to get rid of Aaron.
And Eric Curtis just standing on the neck of Aaron Nova.
Yeah.
What a painful predicament to be in.
Definitely not the position I'd want to be in.
And if Aaron Nova doesn't find a way to turn this around soon, this match is going to be over because he is taking a beating.
It's definitely turned around from the way it started. Aaron Nova had the upper hand all the way, and that turned around somewhere in the middle here, and now Eric... The jerk Curtis is in full control.
And Nova's midsection could be injured here after having the rope kicked into it. We heard him wail in pain, the senton, the boots.
That stupid idiot champion.
He is the DWI light heavyweight champion. Whether we like it or not.
What he lacks in size, he makes up for in pure viciousness.
And he's very cunning. He's smart with what he does. Aaron Nova making his way back into the ring, but he is crawling on all fours, and we can see the end of this matchup soon.
I mean, he's just straight up choking him in front of the referee, and the referee's not going to...
With his own vest and throwing him by his neck.
Well, I guess because Aaron Nova grabbed it, he's not going to, like, come on. I mean, he just did that, right? What is wrong with Ray?
Oh, and Nova reverses the pinfall.
Oh, shoots him out of like a cannon.
Eric Curtis back to his feet first, and he takes Aaron Nova's head off. What a hard-hitting matchup. Action like this is only $5 every other Sunday. Village Shops, Ruskin, Florida.
Oh, my God. Only $5.
And Nova battling from his knees, desperately trying to make his way back to his feet.
First things first, that was just dirty. I mean, like, there was no need for that. it wasn't like it was going south. He seemed to have the upper hand, and he's just like, you know what? I'll just take your eyeballs out of your head. Just raked his eyes.
They said he was here to hurt him. Knife edge chop. Two huge chops, and Nova is in a bad situation.
Eric Curtis telling him he's the champion. Aaron Nova's nothing. I think Nova's starting to take exception to it. It's starting to fire something up in him. Oh!
And he just took Eric Curtis's head off twice. And we're going to see the Novaplex.
Eric Curtis biting out of that Half Nelson.
Shoots him off into the corner. Big back body drop.
Oh, big body drop.
And he just threw Eric Curtis over his head. Nova going for the pinfall. Nova almost had a pinfall on the light heavyweight champ right there.
That beautiful backdrop. That was beautiful.
And you can hear George Rodriguez from the back saying, Nova sucks. We all know they're enemies and don't like each other. And Nova's calling for the end right here with his signature knee strike. Eric Curtis with the reversal.
Eric sees it coming. He swept it out of the way.
And with a submission on the calf and ankle of Aaron Nova. Aaron Nova's in bad shape here in the middle of the ring. Can't reach the ropes.
Trying to hyperextend that tendon.
Dislocate his ankle, pressure on the knee. And Nova using the power of the fans to make it to that bottom rope just barely. It looked like he was going to tap out.
It looked like
out.
The pressure was on the Achilles tendon, like he was trying to pop the Achilles.
He said he was here to hurt people, and he was trying right there. The vicious Eric Curtis.
That's that viciousness I was alluding to earlier.
And he's calling for the end here. Nova hits him with the Novaplex. What an impactful maneuver from Aaron Nova.
He got all of that there. Oh, but only gets a two count. Thought he had him there for sure.
What a huge maneuver. And Aaron Nova has turned things around. Back and forth action. Goes on. No. Reversal.
Oh. No, Nova. Look out. Oh, Nova delivers one back of his sport. Oh, wow. Oh, my
and
God.
And there's the signature knee strike.
Oh, and it gets a 1-2-3. He gets the champ clean.
It looked like Eric Curtis was going to turn things around.
What does
this
mean?
His signature kick. Aaron Nova hits his super kick.
What does this mean for Aaron Nova in the lightweight championship?
It obviously makes him the number one contender after he pins the champion.
Straight up 1-2-3. Without the insurance policy in the corner, I think we see the difference already.
And Nova with his eyes on the DWI Light Heavyweight Championship.
Oh, all the weird things I've been saying all match. But I'm really happy for my boy. And I think real soon he will be holding that up just like that as the DWI Light Heavyweight Champion.
He is letting the jerk Eric Curtis know he is coming for his championship. Eric Curtis obviously not happy about it. Aaron Nova celebrates. What an opening contest. DWI right now, episode 36. And check us out, facebook.com/DWI Wrestling for more information on live events.
Hey, man, I tell you what, that was hard fought. Aaron deserves that. The captain comes out victorious.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the main event, DWI Right Now, episode 36. I'm your host, Alex Green, co-host in the booth.
Anthony Devlin, and there goes those dirty, dirty, dirty Sinful Alliance jumping. Dave Guevara, the Rebel Gorilla, and the shooter, Ray Ayala, their opponents today. Big power slams from the competitors.
Power slams in stereo.
Pardon me, competitors. The
What would you call them? The
DWS Superstars.
That was David, a fly I caught in my hand and chucked at you, by the way.
David Guevara, the first ever two-time DWI heavyweight champion.
Ninja skills.
Ray Ayala, former heavyweight champion, going against the Sinful Alliance, current tag team champions.
Big handful of hair by the champ. Yeah. I'm glad Charles Crane thought better about holding his partner there. He would have been scalped.
What are we going to see here? Just throwing him in by his hair.
All four of these men got a really serious mean streak in them.
All four competitors in this matchup have been able to capture championship gold during their careers at Definitive Wrestling International.
Beautiful double.
Hip toss.
Where am I at?
With Ray Ayala, one half of the Ayala brothers with Mondo Ayala. David Guevara, former two-time DWI Tag Team Champion, Lightning Monroe, Rebel Gorillas, and look at that double hip toss.
There, that's the one I was looking for more.
Snap vertical suplex. Is it safe to say David Guevara learned that at the Academy of Wrestling Sciences?
I believe it's safe to say.
Charles Crane was not happy about that one.
Screaming, it's not happening. That's not happening.
He goes for the big back body drop. The Fleshmaster reverses it.
Big swinging neck breaker.
Pendulum neck breaker.
Drops a knee on his head for extra measure.
And in comes the Colt Classic.
Lifts him aloft. Drops him down on his neck with that leg drop.
Signature Sinful Alliance. But unable to keep the shoulders down for a count of three.
Going to take a lot more than that to put out Dave Guevara.
But Charles Crane putting the beating right now on the heavyweight champion.
Big knees in the corner.
It's safe to say Charles Crane's career has been on the ascent here at Definitive Wrestling International.
He works really, really hard to get better all the time, and it shows.
It shows right there with an enziguri to the back of the head on the champ. Hooks the leg.
It was not pretty, but it was definitely effective. Ray Ayala coming in to break up the pin. I feel had he not done that, the match would be over.
And in comes the sadistic Fleshmaster.
Delivering the toes right in between the ribs. That hurts.
Now the Fleshmaster hails from beyond reality.
I can't believe that.
Where is beyond reality?
I don't know. I can't comprehend it.
Are there more Fleshmasters there? And Ray Ayala just took their head off, came in ball of fire, showing why as a former heavyweight champion. Big back body drop.
Big house on fire.
The 20-year veteran scoops him up. Big scoop slam off the ropes, building a head of steam.
Oh, my goodness. Driving that elbow.
300 pounds of the shooter dropped right across the neck of the Fleshmaster. Now, referee Andrew, the most handsome ref, Jensen, is going to have his hands full in this matchup. Fleshmaster battling back here at the Village Shops as he locks it in. Russian leg sweep. Or should I call it a Beyond Reality leg sweep?
Call it what you will.
Here comes the Colt Classic from Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. And leg drops in stereo. One to the midsection, one to the head, but only a two count. Listen to the fans behind Ray Ayala, the longtime member of the Definitive Wrestling International roster, one of the most respected members of the roster.
And certainly a fan favorite here today.
I just think action like this, only $5.
Unbelievable, only $5. Where can you see live action like this, family-friendly wrestling like this, so close up and personal, for only $5?
Check out facebook.com/DWI wrestling for more info as Charles Crane just levels him with those knees to the spine.
That hurts, no doubt.
And he just kicked him right in the mouth.
And yet again, the team coming out of that corner of Dave Guevara and Rey Ayala break up a pin.
Fleshmaster dropping the leg. I told you the ref would have his hands full. And
there was no real tag there, but the referee was distracted.
He's getting turned around by all the action, the chaos, the commotion.
Safe to say, Fleshmaster, not the legal man.
Right into the ropes. Fleshmaster turning things around here. And he just jumped right on his neck, Tony. Choking him in tandem there.
Utilizing that second rope as a weapon, for sure. A third man, a partner, if you will.
And this is why the Sinful Alliance are the current DWI Tag Team Champions. Fleshmaster springboard to the second rope. Leg lariat.
Big springboard leg lariat again.
Impressive maneuver. And that could have been it.
Hits right on the money. And yet again, the Rebel Gorilla Dave Guevara comes in to break up a pin. I'm no friend of the Sinful Alliance, but come on.
And here comes the Hot Topic highlight reel, the Fallen Sun. Just clubbing the backs of one of his rivals here at DWI, the Shooter Rey Ayala. And now he is just strangling him on the ropes.
Rey Ayala definitely looking worse for wear. Just draped it. Oh! Boot by the Fleshmaster just upside the head. Oops, upside the head, he says.
You can tell the Cult Classic is frustrated with the refereeing in this matchup.
The officiating in this match has definitely not been on the side of the Sinful Alliance. But okay. I mean, really, they really can't complain as much as they cheat.
And what is the Cult Classic going for here?
Looks like he's trying to turn.
And what a reversal, the Shooter.
Uses that core strength to flip him over.
Not how the Cult Classic wanted that to go down. And Rey Ayala is looking to turn things around here.
But the Cult Classic first to his feet.
He says he's got something for him. I've been on the receiving end of this, Tony.
Driving those knees into the midsection of the Shooter.
And
while having his hands clasped, turning and a neck breaker for...
Signature Charles Crane. 1, 2.
Oh my goodness. And well, yet again, another pin breakup by the Rebel Gorilla.
The Rebel Gorilla refusing to let this match end.
Sinful Alliance expressing their discontent for all of these pin breakups.
And the frustration boiling over. Fleshmaster off the ropes. Huge senton right to the midsection. That's 175 pounds of Fleshmaster coming down right on those ribs.
Oh, my goodness.
And look, the frustration boiling over. Fleshmaster goes after David.
Clearly, the Rebel Gorilla has no respect for the referee, the most handsome ref.
Andrew Jensen. And here we're going to see a wishbone.
Oh, I really do hope that the Shooter stretched. Or he's not going to be shooting straight for a while.
And he looks to be in pain here at the Village Shops DWI Volume 201 main event.
Oh my goodness.
He said it's time to go to sleep as he is just choking the life out of the Shooter.
Asking, what time is it? What time is it?
That's twice, Tony. One more time, this matchup is over.
But the arm remains up.
Rey Ayala, last ditch effort to turn things around here.
The Shooter showing some real fortitude, not giving up. Hanging in there, fighting back up. Trying to get up.
The fans trying to will him up to his feet.
Charging, bull charging Charles Crane into the far corner.
And Charles Crane sent for the ride here.
whips him across.
Charles Crane goes for a signature clothesline. Ray Ayala blocks back and forth.
Well, Charles Crane comes off the rope with a big clothesline. Goes back in.
That's two big clotheslines.
Second clothesline.
Can he knock him off his feet?
Rolls up.
And he just took his head off. Only a two count Rebel Gorilla. David Guevara breaks it up, and that could have been it.
Fleshmaster asking how many times is he going to do that. Again, I have to side with the Sinful Alliance.
As much as I dislike the Sinful Alliance, the referee has been very lenient with the Rebel Gorilla in this matchup. And Charles Crane staying on the attack here on the shooter, Ray Ayala. These two have squared off several times here, DWI. And those knees, three of them right to the gut. The shooter, Ray Ayala, reverses the Irish whip, backs it up. Back handspring, elbow signature, Ray Ayala. And both men are down.
The agility of the big guy, using everything he had to get that over, using all his momentum to come crashing into Charles Crane in that corner, developing to put that elbow right in his face.
And all four of these competitors showing why they are the top. David Guevara blocks the punch. And just starts putting the beating on the Fleshmaster. Irish whip sent for the ride.
Bam, elbow drops the Fleshmaster. Big right hand shoots him into the ropes. Clothesline leveling him.
What a lariat. The champ goes for the pin. And a taste of their own medicine.
And you just see a boot come. Oh, big fist. Just see a boot come from outside and just clock or break up that pin, which you're pretty sure would have been over. Fleshmaster in the corner now, taking a beating from the heavyweight champion, David Guevara.
And it is breaking down here at the Village Shops.
Oh, Fleshmaster moves, kicks the champ in the gut, climbs up to the second buckle, sunset flip. David Guevara hanging on.
He can't get the champ over. David Guevara reversing and just drops him on his head. What
just
are we going to see?
Lifts him up and then just slams him on the back of his head.
Charles Crane trying to get back in there.
Setting him up. Boom.
Signature Rebel Gorilla powerbomb. 1, 2, 3.
And the big 1, 2, 3 for the team of the Rebel Gorilla, the heavyweight champ here at DWI, David Guevara, and his partner, the shooter Ray Ayala.
And this has to launch them in the rankings here in the tag team division at DWI. They have to be considered number one contenders for the DWI Tag Team Championship. And what a role it has been, and what a ride it has been for the Rebel Gorilla, David Guevara. The ups and downs, becoming the first ever two-time DWI heavyweight champion, teaming up with Ray Ayala,
well, they
pinning
just,
the tag champs.
They just pinned the tag champs straight up. This has got to set them up pretty. Will he be the first ever heavyweight champion, tag team champion? He's calling for it now. He's saying, do you want to see him be not only the heavyweight champ, but the tag team champs along with Ray Ayala?
And the DWI faithful sound like they want to see
yeah,
it.
Yeah, they're behind it. Dave Guevara reaching out. What's going on here?
Oh my God, what has just happened? Ray Ayala, huge belly-to-back suplex on the Rebel Gorilla off
picking
the rope.
Picking him up, dropping him on his bean, and then delivering one of those elbows into the sternum.
They just won a tag team match against the tag team champions. They were going to go
Wait, what
the
is he...
I think he said he's coming for the heavyweight championship, slapped him and walked out.
I want you.
I can't believe what I'm witnessing here. Village Shops, Ruskin, Florida, DWI, Volume 201.
Oh, well, there's no friends when it comes to gold. When it comes to championship gold here at DWI, it seems that there are no loyalties. And the shooter, Ray.
The target's clearly painted on the Rebel Gorilla's back.
Ray Ayala saying, I don't care about friendships. I want the championship.
David Guevara is going after Ray. He is upset. Look at him, Tony. What an episode of DWI right now.
Folks, we hope to see you back here next time at DWI.